Yeah, hello everyone. Thanks a lot for the introduction. So I'm going to explain you how the system in Switzerland works with the livestock guardian dogs that was built up in the last years. So the first wolf came 1995, and then they started with the first LGDs, livestock guardian dogs, in 1999. They worked with it, and then from 2003 to 2014, they worked in a best practice of way. So there was already coordination at Agridea, but there was not like an official system, so it was just some different project, and there was some money from WWF, from other sites. It was just getting and gaining some experience and doing it best practice way. And then since 2014, there is now an official Swiss system for livestock guardian dogs, and this is all funded by the Federal Office for Environment. So just to give you an overview, the numbers of livestock guardian dogs working in Switzerland during summertime on alpine pastures. So in 2003, it was about 40, and now it's about 220, a bit more. And this is that's the number of livestock guardian dogs, and the 220, it's on about 90 different farms. So the system. As I said, the funding is from the Federal Office for Environment. So then we have a breeding association, it's called HSHCH, and they are responsible for breeding and training the dogs. The members are all farmers, that they are sheep or goat keepers, and they breed and train the dog. I will explain it in detail later. Then we have the different cantons, and there is always one person responsible for the consulting and for livestock protection. And this is, in each canton, it's one person out of the Department for Agriculture. And then we have Agridea, and within Agridea there is the office for the LGDs, and we are responsible for the exam. So each, I will explain it later, but each LGD has to pass an exam before being an official livestock guardian dogs. We are responsible for the coordination and the placement of the livestock guardian dogs, for the monitoring and the controlling. So we are an office, and then we have in addition 6 local consultants, and these are all dog experts, and they are sheep keeper by themselves, so they really, they have the dogs and the sheep, and they know from what they're talking. So just shortly about the association. So there is really defined breeding and training aims. We don't want to just breed with every dog, because we really want to have the best out of it. So to become an official breeder, you have to take some theoretical and practical classes. And afterwards, you're an official breeder and trainer, so your work time is also paid out of this budget from the Federal Office of Environment. They breed 2 different breeds, the Montagne de Pyrénées, Patou from France originally, and the Marimano Abruzzese from Italy. So then the exam for the livestock guardian dogs. Now we have all these trained livestock guardian dogs, and now they have to pass an exam to become an official one. So they are at about 1.5 years. And in this exam we test, first we test like the basic obedience, so if they can go on a leash, if they come, if you call them. Afterwards they are 24 hours with free range sheep, and we check with GPS collars if they stay with their flock or if they just go somewhere, because it's really important that they really stay with their flock. After these 24 hours there is a human they didn't know before. It will, the human will approach the flock with the dog, and we see how the dog reacts. Then we have the same human, but with another dog and companion dog, to see if there is another reaction. And then we also test the reactivity without the flock, with umbrellas and other dogs on a leash. So then if the dog passes this exam, they are ready for placement, and for placement it's the canton and Agridea that is responsible. So, how to receive a livestock guardian dog. As a farmer, you want to protect your livestock. Then you contact the cantonal consultant, and this consulting person will visit your farm, and you will discuss together what kind of protection measure would be good for your specific farm. So in one way, If you have other measures, that's not the topic of this presentation now, it's another way, but if livestock guarding dogs are required and if the content gives it's okay, so they really have to check, is it okay for us if there is livestock guarding dogs working? First, the farmer has to attend a theoretical course, it's about one day, it's just really the basics, and it shows also what big effort these dogs would mean. So after then they can decide, do we really want to have these dogs, or maybe we work better with fences or what else. So if they pass the course and if they still want to have the livestock guarding dogs, then there is this one of these six consultants that will come also to visit the farm, and then they discuss all the details about livestock guarding dogs, if you need some changes in the shed, or if you have, for example, a hiking trail which you could have problems, so you really discuss all these details. And then there is the placement, if there is everything okay and there is some changes made. And I think it's important to say that this whole process takes about 1 year. So if in summertime, if you want to have a dog, it takes, you only won't have the dog for next summertime. So it's really a lot of changes in the farm sometimes. And yeah, it's also that the dogs, we cannot just store them somewhere, so we also have to breed them. So if the dog is placed, then they would get monthly the subsidies for the running costs. Afterwards, it's Agridea that does the monitoring of the dog. So we have a database, and in this database, we have all the registration numbers, and we know everything about the dogs to have an overview. Then also a really big work is the information for the public and the tourists. And then the controlling, so if we have some incidents with biting or if we have damage despite of the livestock guarding dogs, we really do some investigations to try to find out what was the problem. So about the information, yeah, tourism is a big challenge in Switzerland. We have a lot of hikers in the mountains, a lot of mountain bikers. And yeah, the dogs, they are there, they want to protect their flock, and it's not always easy because there's hikers, they don't know about it, or they are really afraid, so it's not nice to meet these huge dogs. So there we have a lot of material, I also have some here. You could watch, it's also in all languages we have in Switzerland. And we also have a movie, How to Behave Towards the Livestock Guarding Dog, on our homepage. Then on the field, we have some standard like boards, signalization boards that shows the hiker that they don't know the livestock guarding dogs how to behave. And now we also have some really specific boards, so you can really see where you are. And then you see, okay, I'm here, there's the hiking way, there's the alpine pasture with the dog. Do I really want to go there? Sometimes we write the number of the shepherd, they could call, are the dogs really there? Because there's also a changing of the pastures during summer, so they are not always the whole summer there, and maybe now they are there. So the most information we can put on, we do. And then what we also have, not since a really long time, it's now the second year, it's that we have on different web pages that are really used by hikers to plan their tour, you can go on it, and then you see all the alpine pastures on which livestock guarding dogs are working on. You can click on it, and it's also sometimes it's also written, for example, here it is the tourism office which we are working often with, or you see maybe there's another route I could take and I wouldn't meet the dogs. It's really to prepare already before, because if you're hiking and then you're just in front of the dog and you know I want to go there, and sometimes it takes hours to take another way, so it's easier if you can already plan it. And then we have a lot of field trips with interesting people to meet with some experts, the dogs, to know how to behave. We have some presentations. We also had the Swiss livestock guarding dogs in TV. And it's really, I think, it's a big topic to really tell all the people what's about with these dogs. And then the controlling of the livestock guarding dogs. So for us, it's really important that we have this investigation of each incidents and claim. So we have the biting incidents there. We call really the owner of the dog. We call the hiker that was bitten. We try to find out what happened and why did it happen. Was it a problem? Was it really the dog that was the problem? Was it a problem of the hiker? Was it a management that you could change? Was it just bad luck? This also happened. Then we also have the same with the damage despite of the LTDs. So it's not often, but it happens that there is two sheep killed and you have the dogs, and then you somehow want to find out what happened because you really want to also improve and you want to learn how it works. Yeah, and then the same thing we do if we have claims. So there is barking claims, if there's really a lot of noise during night, there's strain claims, then we work with GPS collar really to find out. And also, it's the controlling for the livestock garden dogs, it's the data collection for us to improve, and it's also the support for the farmers, because if there once is with a claim, there is a problem with law or something, he's really on the secure side to say, hey, I have an official livestock garden dog, it was controlled, it was another fault. This is the incidence of biting in Switzerland, just to give you an idea. So we have thousands of tourists, and we have about 200 livestock guardian dogs. In blue, you see it's from 2011 to 2017. In blue, you see the humans that got bitten, and in orange, you see the companion dogs that got bitten. It was never a severe bite. It was often scratches or really some small bites. Yeah, but for us, it's really important to have all of these incidents to know what happened. And yeah, maybe the 2017, this blue, there was a lot of human biting. It was 19 persons, so for us that's a lot, because before it was really stable. And for us, it's a bit the explanation that it was really a long summer, a lot of sunny weekends, so we will see how it continues, but I assume it will be stable again. So if you want to have more information, German, French, and Italian, it's fine. English is a part of it, it's in English. Yeah, you can go on our web page and yeah, you can also ask me. Thanks a lot.